Hi, this is Nature Ndoba Kwamana Amo. I am back again with another video. You know, I promised to do a video a day, but you know, there are light situations in our part of the world, so I was having some issues. But I have to do all, like I said, put it all together and let you get to know. Now, today, what am I talking about? I am talking about procrastination. The question is, I always say I'll do something and I'm unable to do it. So how am I able to say something, plan something and be able to do it? And I'll summarize it as, how do you stop or kill procrastination in your life? There are basic things that everyone should understand about what makes you to procrastinate. Now, what makes you to procrastinate is built deep inside your subconscious mind. The subconscious mind is programmed in a way that it has learned from your environment growing up, between when you were in your mother's womb all the way to through age 7 and age 12, and all the things that you see, all the things that you learned, all the things that you do without thinking are all programmed in your subconscious mind. The subconscious mind happens to be 90% of your brain, of your whole mind, 90% of it. Now, things you learned and gathered and picked up from other people, not necessarily your own wishes and desires. Unfortunately, the brain or the mind that contains our wishes and desires, which is a conscious mind, is just 10% of the mind. So anytime you think of something you want to do, and you allow the subconscious mind to debate the conscious mind, the subconscious mind would win. The conscious mind would only win when you persist and constantly force yourself to do the things that the subconscious mind says no to. You would have to do a lot of repetition of that same thing that you want to allow the subconscious mind to accept it. It is the same way you learned how to walk when growing up. You tried many times. The same way you learned how to pronounce your name growing up. The same way you learned how to write your name. You tried it over and over and over again. The same way you learned to be able to recite the letter of the alphabet. You tried them over and over and over again. The same way you tried to count from 1 to 100. You tried them over and over and over again. And as you continue to try and not give up, the subconscious mind accepts it as part of your subconscious mind programs. So anytime you want to count, the subconscious mind just goes to the program installed on how to count, and then you start counting. So anytime you think of something good that you want to do, and you start allowing a debate between the conscious mind and the subconscious mind. The subconscious mind, which carries your comfort zones, sub-programming. Programs that make you feel comfortable, programs that will make you sleep, programs that will make you sit down and not do anything, programs that will not make you progress, because most of those programs were picked up from your environment. They were not actually your wishes and desires. You learned them from other people. You learned them from your parents. You learned them from school. Learned them from the people around you. So they do not necessarily carry the things that you wish and you desire. So if you allow your subconscious mind to take a better part of your consciousness, you would end up not doing anything. It will not allow you to do the things that you would wish to do. So here, there's a simple rule that you can always apply when you want to stop the debate between the subconscious mind and the conscious mind. And that rule is called the 5 seconds rule. There's a book that you can find that gives you all the details on what you need to do on the 5 seconds rule. Now, all the 5 seconds rule actually do is, anytime you get an idea, anytime you want to wake up and your body is telling you no, which your body usually does, anytime you decide to wake up and your body says no, you just count reverse 54321. Immediately you count 54321, the body knows that no, you count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Why are you counting 54321? The subconscious mind stops debating the conscious mind, and then you can go ahead and do what you want to do. You are driving in a cab, or you are walking towards a certain place. Your conscious mind tells you to take a certain direction. The subconscious mind tells you to do otherwise. Immediately, the first decision comes. You count 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and then you go ahead and do it. And you end up doing the things that you want to do at the right time. And with this simple process, you will be able to kill procrastination forever in your life. If you want further explanations on this, just contact me on 0244-66-1011. My name is Nichiren Papamna Amu. You can call me Mr. Smooth. I'll be back some other time with another education.